you're tired of dealing with the headache of scattered product information across multiple spreadsheets, then know that A, you're not alone, and B, you're watching the right video. I'm Mikey with Plitix, and today I'm gonna make your selling life a whole lot easier by showing you how to merge product information from various spreadsheets in both Google Sheets and Microsoft Excel. I'll go over the different methods in each system and their respective pros and cons before finishing up with a sneak peek of a third software option that, to be honest, puts those other two to shame. If you're already using Sheets, Excel, or just want to skip ahead to mystery option number 3, then feel free to use the chapter links here. I won't take it personally, I promise. For now though, let's get started with Google Sheets. Before we dive into the details, let me clarify a few terms. In Google Sheets, a spreadsheet is the entire file, while a sheet is one tab or part of that file. Also, when I talk about a master spreadsheet in this video, I'm talking about the spreadsheet that I want to contain all my data in the end. But when I say original spreadsheet, I mean a spreadsheet that currently contains some of my data and that I want to get the data out of. Basically, original spreadsheet, source, master spreadsheet, destination. Right, let's move on. There are two main methods to merge your spreadsheets. Method one involves copying data from an original spreadsheet into your master spreadsheet, essentially creating a separate copy that you can do what you want with. The other method is creating a link between an original spreadsheet and your master spreadsheet, which gives you a constantly updated view of its data. However, you won't be able to make any edits in the master spreadsheet. To copy data, you've got a few options. Firstly, we have the classic copy-paste. Just select the data you want to copy in your original spreadsheet, then click Copy, Command C, Control C, whatever you prefer, then head over to your master spreadsheet and paste it there. Option 2, the import function. With this, you select the file you want to copy data from by going to File and then Import, whether that file is hosted on Google Drive or on your computer. Then you choose the import options that suit your needs. For multiple spreadsheets with different formatting and naming conventions, you want to go for Insert New Sheet. That way, the data will be copied into separate sheets that you can then edit before combining everything into one sheet, if you want to do that. If your original spreadsheet or spreadsheets share the same formatting or naming conventions as your master spreadsheet, you might prefer to combine them into one sheet immediately by choosing Append to Current Sheet. This will add the data from each one to the same sheet directly under the data that's already there, which is why it's super important to get all the columns in the same order and so on as in your master spreadsheet before you do this. It can be worth the effort though, since having all your data in one sheet will then speed up your export process significantly, but more about that later. The copy sheet function is another way. You'll need to have both your master and original spreadsheets in Google Sheets for this to work. Select the sheet you want to copy, then choose Copy To from the menu that appears there. Then Existing Spreadsheet, then select your master spreadsheet. It will create a copy of that sheet with the name Copy Of Sheet Name. You can repeat this process for each original spreadsheet you want to merge. If you prefer linking your spreadsheets, so seeing a live update of your data that you're keeping elsewhere, you can use the Import Range formula. This method requires everything to be hosted on Google Sheets. You select the sheet and cell where you want the linked data to appear and type in the formula you can currently see on screen, with URL being the link to your original spreadsheet, sheet name being, well, the exact name of the individual sheet you want to link, and then cell range being the cell selection you want. Pay close attention to things like spelling and punctuation, by the way. If you don't include the quotation marks or spaces, for example, it won't work, as I discovered. Like I said, if you link your spreadsheets in this way, then changes in the original spreadsheet will automatically update in your master spreadsheet. However, you can't edit the linked data in the master spreadsheet. The second you try, this happens. When you're ready to export your master spreadsheet, you can download it as a file or create a URL for others to access. But remember, if you're using the copying method, you'll need to manually repeat the import or copy process whenever there are changes. Okay, so Microsoft Excel. There are two main methods to merge spreadsheets in Excel, much like with Google Sheets, seeing as again you can choose to create either a new separate copy of your data that you can edit, or a link between two spreadsheets that gives you an up-to-date view of your original spreadsheet but that can't be edited directly in the linked version. I'm using Excel 365 here, which is the free online version. The essential ideas of these methods are more or less the same though, whether you're using Excel online or the paid application on your computer. You just might find some of the function names vary a bit. On a related note, just a heads up, Excel refers to a spreadsheet, as in the entire file, as a workbook, but still refers to the individual tabs or pages in that workbook as sheets. I'm going to keep saying spreadsheets and sheets to be consistent though, because at the end of the day, a workbook is still a spreadsheet. Plain and simple. Right, back to merging data. To create a copy, the simplest option with Excel, again, is the classic CNV, or copy and paste, if you prefer. Just select the data you want to copy from your original spreadsheet, copy it, head over to your master spreadsheet, select where you want to put it, and paste it there. Easy. You've then got a copy of your data to edit as you wish, and that you can therefore adjust for whatever purpose you need, but that you will need to manually update on a regular basis. Interestingly, Excel 365 doesn't appear to have the option to import whole files or sheets at a time via upload or through the options on your master spreadsheet. The only thing you can do is upload your file or files to OneDrive, Microsoft's online storage option, by using the upload button on the Microsoft 365 homepage, and then open them there. Select the data or sheet you want, and again, copy paste. So essentially, it would seem that copying and pasting isn't just the simplest option, it's your only option. Well, not quite. Just like with Google Sheets, you've also got the option to link your spreadsheets. This is pretty straightforward in Excel Online, since they've added some shortcuts to speed up the process and given you two ways to do it. Here are your choices. Option one, pasting a link. Select the data range you want to link to in your original spreadsheet, then copy it, head back to your master spreadsheet, and click on Paste Link in the dropdown just here. You'll need to allow access between your spreadsheets for this to work by clicking on the warning bar that appears. But once you've done that, you should see your original spreadsheet's data reflected in your master spreadsheet. Option two, creating a workbook link. For this method, you need to have both spreadsheets open at the same time, and this time we're starting in the master spreadsheet. Select the cell where you want the data to appear, and then just type in equals. Then go to your original spreadsheet, select the data you want to link, and press enter. Again, you'll need to allow access, but after that, you'll see a reflection of all the relevant data in your master spreadsheet. See, I told you it was pretty straightforward. There is an interesting difference between Excel and Google Sheets to be aware of here though, and that's what happens if you try and edit linked data. While in Google Sheets, any edits will break the link and make everything disappear, in Excel, the link actually works on a cell-by-cell basis. What does that mean for you? Well, simply that if you edit one cell, then yes, it will break the link for that cell, but the rest of the cells will stay connected and automatically update themselves on a regular basis. If you're conscious of this and manage your data with that in mind, this can give you more flexibility in terms of being able to edit some parts without losing the link completely. But you will then need to be careful and remember that anything you've edited, even to add a currency symbol, for example, will then not be linked to the original spreadsheet and therefore will not update itself. For all of these methods, you have a decision to make. Keep the data from your original spreadsheets in separate sheets in your master spreadsheet, or combine everything into one sheet. Or to put it another way, decide if you want to get your sheet together. When making this choice, it helps to consider your specific needs and the fact that a lot of systems can only process one sheet at a time. Uploading a spreadsheet with multiple sheets isn't going to work, and you'll either find your upload fails or that only the first sheet gets processed. That's why combining sheets in your master spreadsheet can speed up your data uploads to other platforms, since then you've got everything in one sheet ready to be uploaded to each of your sales and marketing channels. It is more work though, since it requires consistent formatting across the board, which means either maintaining strict guidelines in your original sheets directly, or by adjusting the copy you've made in your master spreadsheet before adding it to your main sheet. Leaving them separate sheets, on the other hand, gives you more flexibility in terms of formatting, since each sheet can have different columns in a different order. But it does then mean you'll have to upload each sheet individually to wherever you need to send your data. These limitations are just a couple of reasons why, speaking in general, using spreadsheets as your main database might not be the most efficient choice for your business and your product data. And if you want to know more about why that is, just check the description for more information. Now, let's quickly go over the pros and cons of each method, regardless of which software you're using. Copying your data allows data editing, which means you can then prepare it for export to other destinations. However, you've got the synchronization issue. Every time something changes with your data, you're going to have to manually update your master spreadsheet yourself, using whichever method makes the most sense for you. But ultimately, probably means jumping back and forth between a whole bunch of different spreadsheets. Linking your data, on the other hand, provides synchronization, but restricts data editing. You can see the most recent version of your data from your various original spreadsheets in one place, but you can't change anything there without breaking the link in some way. So any formatting or editing has to be done in the originals themselves. Ultimately, that means, you guessed it, jumping back and forth between a whole bunch of different spreadsheets. However, as promised, there is a third option, and this one involves significantly less jumping. The simple fact is, after a certain point, spreadsheets just aren't going to cut it anymore, because they just don't have all the functionality you need to set up an efficient database. To do that, your best bet is going to be finding software that's specifically designed for that purpose. For product information, so all of your products, details, specifications, multimedia, and so on, the best alternative to spreadsheets has to be product information management, or PIM software. PIM tools streamline data collection, organization, and distribution for a more efficient product management process, and come with all sorts of features to help save you time, like bulk editing functions, the ability to create automated feeds for your sales and marketing channels, and storage for all your digital assets. In the context of merging spreadsheets, though, the big thing here is that it gives you the best of both the linking and copying methods. Set up a PIM tool correctly, and it will always have the latest version of your product information, thanks to the fact that it can update itself on a schedule you set, using data feeds linked to wherever you're getting your product information from. You can then edit that data in the PIM system without breaking that link. And again, there are loads of functions that can help you speed up the process. One really cool trick is that you can get it to reformat your data automatically for whatever sales or marketing channel needs it, but without actually changing the original version in your PIM tool. It can transform data for you at the same time as sending it out. Oh, and depending on where you're sending your data, you can often get your PIM system to do all of this on an automated schedule too. Basically, it's a way to get all your latest product information in one place, quickly prepare it for export, and then distribute it to wherever it's needed, whenever it's needed. It's kind of a game changer. And if you'd like to learn more about PIM systems, or even get a free account and test it out for yourself, then check the resources I left in the description. But anyway, there you have it, a guide to merging product information from multiple spreadsheets. I hope this was helpful, and if you're looking for more efficient ways to manage your data, do consider exploring the various other apps and software options available. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe for more data management tips and tricks. See you next time.